Let's learn how to easily create your own online newspaper with content you can get from just about anywhere with Scoop.It. And this is Scoop.It at Scoop.It. And this is a program that allows you to use social networks to easily populate a newspaper that you create. And let's take a look at how this works. It's really easy. You can register for Scoop.It for free. As you see here, it's going to remember my email and password to log in. And I'm going to show you something that I've created to help you understand Scoop.It. So I created a newspaper with Scoop.It called Results Only Learning. And as you see here, it says my curated topic. So what you are is a curator of information. You gather information on your topic and Scoop.It publishes that information. So let's take a look at Results Only Learning. So you see what I have is some content that I've already created, and we'll take a look at that in a moment. But then what Scoop.It does, which is really nice, is it is going to suggest content based on how you set up Scoop.It. So you're going to give it some parameters in your settings, and it will then curate information or gather information, which you'll curate based on that. So what I'll do is come to manage on my dashboard, and I would just I could come down to manage sources and click into that, and you see here are some of my selected sources. These are places that I want Scoop.It to go to gather information about my topic. And I have set that up and also entered keywords up here. So Results Only Learning is about progressive education, so I've put that in there. Results Only Learning is now a keyword that's showing up around the internet. Narrative feedback, because Results Only Learning is about feedback and collaboration, and a paperless classroom, because it's about technology integration. So then what Scoop.It is going to do is it's going to go through these social media and it's going to find information and it's going to populate my Scoop.It newspaper, which I am calling Results Only Learning. So if I want to see what this looks like, I can come over and click View Topic, and it's going to take me to my Scoop.It Results Only Learning paper. And you can make one of these on any topic. So you see I've got some things that have come in from various places. It says to the reader, Scooped by Mark Barnes. And so here's a story. It's got the word collaboration in it. Here's one that came from my blog, Role Reversal, so people could take a look at that. And again, they're just going to click into these, and these stories will come up, and it'll bring in all kinds of things, blogging about the Web 2.0 connected classroom, because I've added a lot of technology integration. So as you can see, this is really nice because Scoop.It does the work for you. Another option is to just add a post from here. So once I'm in Results Only Learning, if I want to, I can add something that I find. So let's say that I've been surfing around and I find something. I like this site, Edudemic, so I see this article that I like. I can copy the web address to that. I can come back to my Scoop.It newspaper. I can paste in that URL, and then I can just go ahead and add that. Now I can write a post as well, as you can see, write a post without any URL. So I can actually post content to my Scoop.It paper without adding anything from the internet, almost like blogging. Okay, so I can add an image, I can add content here if I want, and I can just say post, and then Scoop.It will add this post to my newspaper. As you can see, it's there, and that's really fantastic. So what you're doing is you're curating information on a topic. You could use this in a classroom. You could have your students curate information. You could put information up and make this a source that they would check often. So as you can see, Scoop.It is a very powerful tool, and that is Scoop.It at Scoop.It. Give it a try.